power, air, the elders, the wisest, and playful water, the youngest. Together, they forged life. Air chose not to meddle with life, but rather let it choose its own path. Fire did not care much for life, favoring solitude in the skies. However, water could not resist this great playground, and she swam the oceans. And the myth of her was created on the lips of all who lived there. Some even believed that she had created us, the fish people, and so we passed our dead to her as a gift. And soon, she forgot a time when she had been hungry. The elder sisters, who had decided not to play with life, still influenced us. From fire radiating in the skies came warmth and strength, and from air echoing the other, we learned to breathe above the oceans, and, as time passed, we evolved. We spoke, we built, and we learned how to create fire, and, ultimately, she too came to walk among us. This was a new world to the water sister, who had been living alone in the sky. She grew curious at the fish people, who had invited her to their world, and we saw in her a new goddess, perhaps stronger and wiser. And one day, water noticed that the world's no longer an infinite twig. She was forced to leave her home, travel back to the fish people, and influence their dreams once again.
Thank you.